Now, what can we expect from the Grants Pass Cavemen basketball team this year in terms of style of play?
So we have 5 games before we play the biggest game of our season.
Hey, protect the cave on 3, 1, 2, 3, protect the cave!
Hey, phenomenal job on defense.
A style of play, you're going to see us try to speed the game up.
He has always been our motto for the past couple years, but one new one that we have added is grit.
Lincoln and Sherwood, first 2 games of the season, they're going to be pretty tough teams, but I think that we'll compete really well with them, and then I think the rest of the conference is going to be pretty light for us this year.
Looking pretty good. Team's looking, you know, sharp. Try to dial in a few things and get that chemistry rolling.
Yeah, we only got to worry about South Med, maybe, and Roseburg is not good.
But the way these boys have been working every day, season looking good. I'm hoping to see them win, make good run in playoffs.
Yeah, I think we'll have a really good year. Honestly, we should win the league, but if we don't, then we're doing something wrong.
Peter Dubin Gym, ladies and gentlemen, here a Saturday afternoon up there with the Grants Pass Cavemen hosting the Sherwood Bowmen. On the drive, down left-hand side. Bounce pass to McLean, corner left-hand side. 3 all the way, and it's good. A bounce pass to the high post. That's Bruder. Stuffs one home. Shot is up in the wing, left-hand side. It's up and good. The ball stolen away by Deshane. Lead pass out to McKittrick. All the way, lays one up, that is good. That's McIntosh, that's Timac. To McLean, right-hand side to Jesse. Jesse left-hand side to Morgan. Morgan goes up, lays one up, that's good. And he was fouled, he'll go to the free throw line. No defense on him, so he brings it all the way down. Shoots the ball down low to McLean on the cut, lays one up. And to Bruner, wing right-hand side, elevate, shoot to meet team beat, and Bruner hits it. Down cleared by McIntosh, outlet comes to McLean, breaking to the floor, in the basket, lays one up and in. Shovels down low to Morgan. Morgan hard to the glass. It's up and good. First basketball again stolen away by Grants Pass. Picked up by Hart. Lead pass out to shot is up and good for number 23. That's the length of the floor. Pulls up, lays one up. That is good. He was fouled.
She is the black sheep. Even if we wanted to, the clock cannot be weak. Watch me swing like this. Why should I swing it like that? Because in fact, for me, it might not attract.
Vincent Techman, it's out and right click on the Grants Pass Cavemen here at Heater Duma Gym. Now again, loose basketball picked up by McLean. McLean does the lead pass out to McIntosh. Lays it up off glass, and it's good. Ball up to McIntosh. Heavy pressure, ball goes down low to Morgan. Morgan hard to the glass, and Morgan has 6 tonight. As Jesse stays with him, shoulder to shoulder all the way down. Ball out front. Deshane picks it up, he's out in front of everybody. Rolls to the left-hand side, hooks one up, that is good. Going back to Carter in the paint, and a player control foul called on the freshman. Tied to McLean into the forecourt, into the paint, elevates, 10 footers on the way, and it's good against Jesse. Jesse gets a hand on the pass, Rosetta picks it up, outlet to Bruner, late pass to Rosetta, late to Adota. Jesse was tough to hold. Bounces on the floor, goes up once, draws the foul, and gets the shot up and down. Dillon with the basketball, goes over the shots, that's deflected, picked up by Rosetta. Looks for a reset. Flips the ball to Deshane. He elevates its free throw line and nails it. Shovels left-hand side to Jesse. 4-3 from the wing, left-hand side. It's good. She threw traffic. A little head fake. Flips the ball right-hand side of the corner to McLean for 3 from the corner. Nails it. Rebound in the hands of Rosetta. Pumps once, goes back for the shot. That is good. Off the key. Kicks one out left-hand side. There's a loose basketball. And chased in. Finally picked up by McIntosh. Up to the glass. It's good. And McIntosh gets his ninth point in the basketball game. And the Texans go home without a win here at Southern Oregon.
Bring us up today on what happens after Christmas here for the Cavemen, because you're headed to San Diego.
Yeah, we're going to San Diego. We leave at 2 a.m. in the morning, basically Christmas night, the 26th, right? And so after we get to San Diego, I'm going to have the boys take a nap, and then we'll do some team activities. And then that following morning, we play at 9 a.m. At the hosting schools.
That was the biggest bonding of our year. That was so much fun. And even the games, having to wake up at 6 a.m. to go play a 9 a.m. game. But even though we lost, after 30 minutes of the game, we're in San Diego. And so we really bonded.
I mean, the San Diego trip was really fun. I mean, obviously, like, we get to go play some games, but the most important part was just team bonding, especially early in the season for us.
Yeah, San Diego was really fun. It was more of the bonding for our team, especially since we have like those five seniors, and then after that, they're not really close with anybody else.
Especially Jordan. Jordan coming in as a freshman, that was really, really hard, and probably really scared for him, but I think he fit in well, especially after that trip.
I think that San Diego was a very positive thing for us. Big time, because we really came together towards the end. We had a big meeting in the seniors' room, and we were kind of lost before that game, like before that night. And then we had a big meeting, the seniors all talked, and then everyone else kind of talked, but the thing that made it different was Lackey came in the room just out of nowhere, telling us to go to bed, but he sat down and talked to us all about our roles, what we're supposed to be doing here, and what we need to get better at. And I think that really helped us go into league stronger.
I think most definitely helped us, because that last win got us to 500 going into league. So I think that gave us a little more motivation.
Coming back from San Diego, going to North Med, I mean, that was a big difference, especially because we went those first two games and we lost them, but we kind of, Coach Nate kind of like explained it as like getting punched in the face, and we finally did something back that third game. So I feel like we kind of caught fire at the end of that tournament, and that kind of pushed us going into league like we're ready to go.
Basketball opener tonight, the Grants Pass Cavemen hosting the Black Tornado of North Medford High School. Attacks the basket, goes up and finds two, so Grants Pass answers with a field goal. Into the hands of Jesse, out to McLean. McLean drives all the way, lays one up. McLean on the drive for Grants Pass in the paint. Underhanded layup is up and good. Bounce pass right hand side to McLean. Controls the basketball. Kicks it back out to McIntosh for three. It's good. Good work down low. He's a big guy. Ball out front. Stolen away by McIntosh. Shovels left hand side to Jesse all the way, and he stuffs it home. No good. Rebounded by Rosetta. Rosetta. Baseball throw out to McIntosh. Out in front of everybody. Lays it up and in, and McIntosh. Five spins into the bank, kicks the ball left-hand side in the corner, shot for three on the way. And this one is good by Bruner. Zeta, left-hand side on the wing, hands it right back to McLean, launches the three immediately and buries it. Rosetta rebounds and puts it back up and in, and he's fouled. Penetrates, gets the ball down a little more. He's got room, lays it up and in. There's one. So we're pretty even so far, 33-26 to score. Grants back, and it's McLean on the drive, kicks it right-hand side in the corner to McIntosh, out front then to Jesse. Jesse back out to McLean, 24-footer by McLean, is good! Wow! McIntosh looks for a pick, then rolls through, shot is up, and good! He was fouled, he'll go to the free throw, picks up his ninth point in the contest. Turner puts the ball on the floor, head fakes, drives all the way, kisses it off glass, it's good! Rosetta picks up the rebound again. Wills muscles one up, that's good. Jackson left-hand side, gets the rebound back finally. Again, muscles one up, that's good. Bruner can't do it. Stripped the basketball by Jesse. Jesse's out in front all the way. Kicks the ball left-hand side to McIntosh. Over to Bruner, and Bruner lays it up and in. So the Cavemen move the ball around a little bit. Final score, a 20-point win for Grants Pass. 63-43. We'll be right back and recap.
Boys got super excited. You know, we preach during the preseason, you know, everything we do, whether we win or lose in the preseason, all it is a builder so that we can win league. That's all that matters. And so, you know, through our ups and downs, through our preseason,
Winning that first North Medford game was kind of a we can do this.
I think that was definitely a big step for us, especially we played North Med last year at their place first game, and we came in with the same mentality, but we ended up, like, I'd say not following through that mentality the whole game. And our mentality going into this game was that we weren't gonna let it happen again.
I think, well, honestly, everything was just falling that game for us, and their best player couldn't get going at all. I think he had like 4 points, and then, yeah, I mean, it tells it right there. It stops, and bucket's going in the hoop for us.
I mean, playing North Med, they are ups and downs, and so we kind of put them down and kept them down, and that's how we came out with the victory in that one at home. And we used energy.
And we just weren't gonna let off the gas that game, just run up the score if we have to, not let them get back in the game.
We were just super confident the whole time. Like, there was no doubt in my mind that we were gonna beat them. And I just believed that with all my heart, and I tried forcing that down everyone else's throat, like, we're gonna win this game. And I think that helped for sure, power through and just dominate them.
Well, I know I have a good friend on that team that him and I have been battling with each other for a long time. And so to come out and play well that game and to beat them by 20 felt really good. And after that game, we felt really high going into the rest of the league. Oh.
Starting to ramp up, you know, a little bit. The boys are starting to get more and more confident and starting to believe that, no, this is our year, you know.
Coming into the South Medford game, I was ready. I wanted to win. I wanted to beat them real bad.
We've been playing against these kids since we were little, and we never seemed to beat them, like, ever in my whole life.
I was at the Cascade Christian St. Mary's game, and one of the other players on South Medford came up to me and telling me how much they were gonna beat us by and how we were terrible. And so I let the team know what he said, and we were practicing with fire and playing with fire, and that's how we played during that game.
Ball out front in to Morgan. Morgan left hand side to Rosetta. Rosetta, free throw line jumper to McLean. It's up and good, and the Cavemen are on the board.
Lindahl.
Lindahl left hand side to Dolan, and Dolan drops his shoulder. And it's an offensive foul. Shot is off, no good, but Bruner follows and he gets his first two of the Haven. Crosses the timeline, moves to the right hand side to the free throw line, penetrates, goes up with a shot off glass, and it's good for McLean. Tries to work inside, kicks the ball back out to McLean for three on the way, it's good. Loses the basketball, it's picked up by ball long pass down to Morgan. He goes to the glass, and this one's up and down, and it's a get to him, back out front to Bruner, then down low to Rosetta. He spins, a little hook shot is up and good. Wheeling out front, moves to the left-hand side. Ball slapped away out of bounds by Morgan. Wheeling looks down low as a post player goes down low. Ball stolen away by Morgan. Morgan gets the ball right back to McLean. It's a triple team. Ball slapped away. Loose basketball picked up by Bruner. The paint spins, kisses it off glass, and it's good. Down low to Bruner on the right-hand side. Cross court to DeShane. Launches the three this time. Rims and ball through. It is good. Jesse right-hand side has room top of the key. Didn't cut. Back left-hand side. Then to McLean for three, and it's good. Johnson back left-hand side. Shot is elevated and deflected by Bruner. Picked up by McLean on the baseline of the key. Double team gets the ball right back to Morgan. He goes hard to the glass, gets it up and down. Left on the flag, on the drive, right-hand side, elevates off glass, and it's good for Jesse. 37-33 is the final score, and the Panthers are victorious here at Grants Pass.
South Med's been our nemesis, right? They've won it, 7, 8, 10 years in a row. I don't even know how far back, but, this is something that the boys really, really wanted to win against South Medford at home. They realize if they win that game also, we're in first place.
We were dialed in. I mean, first three quarters, we were smacking them all up and down, offense, defense, rebounds, everything.
And we started out really hot. We won the first, second, and third quarters, and we were going.
The best player had 4 points at halftime, I think, again. And then fourth quarter, I think he scored their best player scored eight straight, and then they took the lead after he hit a three, and then after that we just couldn't fight back no more. I guess there's nothing left in the tank.
That fourth quarter is where we kind of just started to die off, and that's kind of where we lost the game.
It was definitely a tough pill to swallow. I mean, me personally, I definitely did not have my best game there. It was probably my worst offensive game.
Playing Lincoln and Sherwood, just us hanging into those games, felt like it gave us the ability to stay in there and possibly beat South. And so I had my confidence up as much as I possibly could during that game. And I thought that we were gonna win that game, for sure.
We came in like we were supposed to, we just weren't able to finish it out.
My head was, I was still there. I was still happy and excited because knowing that we can because that right there, that proved that we can hang with the big dogs and we can actually might be able to do something this year.
Like they kind of really felt like they were going to win that game and they fully believed it. It wasn't like teams in the past that I've coached that they're like, well, we might win if this happens or this happens, right? I think everybody in that room believed that was going to be our game that night.
Going up to Roseburg playing at their home is really tough. I mean, you don't want to say it, but the refs, I mean, it's pretty bad, but.
I'll just put it out there, why not? Roseburg, they went out to the free throw line 31 times to our 12. And honestly, this year we're the second ranked team with points allowed. In the state of Oregon of 6A. Last year we were first, this year we were second. We were 40 points behind Oregon City. So for us to go up there and give 31 free throws is not us at all. And that's the difference in the game.
Ready to kill at that point. Team's ready to go. We're two losses deep right now. And then it showed.
We weren't happy because we definitely, that was such a winnable game. And so if we would have won that game, I think we could have won every single game throughout the rest of the season.
I mean, going into South Eugene, that game, that first time we play them, I mean, it goes back, we lose two games in San Diego, we get punched in the face and we just get sick of it.
I had no doubt in my mind. I thought we had that game for sure. And we held the lead the entire game, it felt good. And me and Peyton both did very well that game.
Because Peyton had 27, Luke had 22, I think. Like, yes. We knew that they didn't have a big dude that could guard and keep up with our big guys, so game plan was just give the ball to the bigs the whole game and let them go to work.
We kind of used the same energy there, and we just got back, and I mean, it was personal. Not to South Eugene, but it was personal to the us to the league.
Then Sheldon, that was great game because they were coming into it thinking they were going to blow us out by 20.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to Heater Newman Gym. Let's set the scene for you.
As a coaching staff, we really, really win and lose games by defense.
The Sheldon Irish in town tonight. At any rate, we've got a pretty good crowd on hand tonight for what promises to be a pretty exciting basketball game. We'll tell you more. One more. This time Morgan comes down with it. He muscles one up, and he gets it up and down. Little collision controls the basketball, though. Gives it to McIntosh, breaking down the lot. Fee feeds off to Morgan, and Morgan has four. Grass pass down by two. Ball in the hands of Jesse. Jesse elevates, goes hard to the glass himself. He's looking good now. Trip to the basketball, gets it right back, flips the ball out to McLean for three, buries it. To McLean, bounce pass down low to Bruner. Bruner fakes, drives, shot is up off glass, rolls through, and Bruner gets it. We count him down, 3-2. Shot is up from Jesse, shot is up, and good. Rosetta comes down the paint, muscles one up, it's good. Slides to the right-hand side. Spins, tries to move in on DeShane. They're going to call an offensive foul on him. He bumped DeShane. Rosetta spins, comes down the paint, muscles one up off glass, it's good. That's the way the first half will end. 28-19 to score. The Cavemen lead by 9. Morado goes up, and the ball taken out of his hands quickly by McIntosh. Dropped the ball in the lane, picked up by Jesse. Jesse back up to Bruner. Bruner in the paint, elevate, shot is up, and good for Bruner. It's left, comes inside to Rosetta. Rosetta, free throw line jumper, nails it. Hand side to McIntosh. Then to Rosetta for three from the corner. He hits the three. Back up was good by McLean. The line comes back right hand side to McLean. Bounce pass down low to Bruner. He's got room. Blaze went up and in. Bruner right hand side to Morgan, who puts it up and in. So the Cavemen move the ball around and find 2 points. Down low then to Morgan. Backhanded layup is up and good. High post, the ball goes to Bruner. Morgan drops down low. Morgan follows, but left hand side to McLean, and he buries the three. Grants pass. The ball goes down low to Morgan. Morgan in the paint. Elevates. Goes up with a shot that's good. And the score of the Grants pass. Cavemen 50 and the Sheldon Irish 37. Good night, everyone.
Going against Sheldon's never a fun thing, but it's always good to get him and beat him, which is awesome. I mean, and that video at the end was pretty funny.
I don't mean it in a disrespectful way, but like they were more like the Olympic team where I was like, okay, like we should win this, and like it's like we need this, and then we move on to the next.
I really wasn't worried, honestly. After South Eugene, I felt like I thought we were gonna pop off again.
I got sick right after we played our second game. Like we just started our second league round. We just went to Willamette and we came back. I think it was about 2 days after. I felt really sick, and it felt like, I didn't feel sick yet actually. It felt like this whole entire left side of my throat was all swollen. And my parents wanted me to take the day off and go to the doctor the next day. The doctor said there's a chance I might have mono. I was just hoping I didn't have mono. And that last day right before I was gonna come back to school, the test came back and I ended up having mono, and I couldn't play for a month because there's a chance I could rupture my spleen because it enlarges. And me personally, I've already had internal bleeding once before and it wasn't fun. And I had to take the tough decision to sit out the rest of the year.
And for only playing six league games, his stats were phenomenal. I don't think people realize. I think everybody focuses, you know, on Luke and Peyton and Gavin as being our main scorers, but the stuff that T-Mac did on the floor, he could have well been, if he'd have played all league, I think T-Mac could have probably been a first teamer, first team all conference, with the numbers that he was doing and how he was doing it and stuff like that. So losing T-Mac was a big deal to us coaches. Some of the players may have not thought that, or some of the other crowd didn't think that, but the coaching staff knew T-Mac was a huge part of our success because he's one of our few two-way players that could score at a high level and defend at a high level.
The two wins going into the second half of the league was big. I mean, we really needed that momentum. But I mean, going into North Medford, I feel like we weren't all focused, I feel like.
That night was a weird night, you know. Their coach got not fired, but he got suspended for that game. So all their seniors that night, and that team is a heavily laden senior, the coach's son's on there. They're crying before the game, and then all of a sudden I see this one point over there at North Medford where the boys are just like, we're winning this for coach.
Well, North Medford, that was the first game I had started all season. So I knew I had to come out and play and show them why I belonged. And my friend who's on that team was also saying some stuff to me, so I knew I was gonna come out and play with fire. But when we showed up for layup lines, it seemed like we were dead.
I mean, like as I said, North Med is highs and lows, and they rode the high that game, and we rode the low, I guess. So.
Evidently, as elementary, they want to serve on eventually. Trooping out of state for a plate. Knowledge, the coat was put without the garbage. We'd all have the top dollars. Imagine everybody flashing, fashion, designing clothes. Lacing it quick up with diamond rolls. Your people know the gold, no parole, no rubbers. No before, imagine more with no undercovers. Just a force for the mind. I take a glimpse into time, watch the memory, the world is mine.
We just couldn't play defense. Like, I don't know. We just went out. Someone grabbed our defense and threw it out the window. It wasn't there.
At halftime, I think we all came together. We started talking. We were like, we're not losing this game. Like, we got to come back right now.
You got to give it all you got right now. We're a better team. Let's go take it. We're down to 14. Roseburg, we're fine. We just got to play our style of D. Come on.
Tricking six digits on kicks and still holding trips to Paris. I symbolize every savage. Give me one shot, I turn trite life to lavish. Political prisoner set free, stress free. No work release, purple M3s and jet skis. Feel the wind breeze in West Indies. I let Coretta Scott King, mayor of the cities, and reverse things to Willie's. It sound foul, but every girl I meet, I go downtown. I open every cell in Attica, send them to Africa.
The final score,
and we couldn't finish in overtime. It was rough.
You love to hear the story how the thugs live in worry, ducked down in car seats, heaps mandatory. Running from Jake, getting chased, hunger for pigs. These are the breaks, many mistakes go down out of state. Wait, I had to learn to marinate. We carry weights, trying to get laced. Put the ace back to safe. Millionaire planning, keep the gap with the cock camera. Making moves in Atlanta, back and forth scramble. I'm gonna be in it. Sky's the limit. I push it 2, 4, 5, 10. It's gonna be my soul.
68-62. The Cavemen lose by 6. We'll be back and recap it all for you folks after this 2-minute Caveman timeout.
Yeah, after the loss of South Eugene, I mean, me personally, I kind of lost focus, like, with basketball. I was kind of like, okay, we can't win league anymore. Time to focus on track.
After that South Eugene loss, that really hurt, and that was really tough, especially after beating them that first time and knowing we could have beat them the second time.
I mean, once it got up to that game, I was like, okay, I want to beat South Med one more time before I'm done with basketball.
I don't even know if we're making playoffs at this point. This will be my last high school basketball game playing against these kids that I've been playing against since I was little, and I want to at least get one more win.
I mean, everyone was fully locked into that game. After losing to North Med and South Eugene, I think that going into that game, we could have been the most prepared we could have been.
We were all hyped up and ready for it. That 30-minute bus ride, we were talking game plan and everything.
Honestly, I felt like our boys were ready. You know, I felt like they really wanted that game.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the home of the Panthers. That is Dennis Murphy Court here at South Medford High School for a clash between the number 3 team in the Southwest Conference and the number 1 team in the Southwest Conference. Ball tipped out front, tipped away by Morgan. Morgan picks it up, takes it to the length of the floor, goes up and is fouled on the far end. He'll go to the free throw line. The hands of the Panthers, number 22, left-hand side, Adi back out front. Get the ball to McLean. McLean on the drive, goes all the way in the paint, lays one up. That is good. Zach Duchesne brings the ball down, goes left-hand side to Jesse. Back out front to Bruner. Left-hand side then to McKittrick. Back out front to Duchesne. Duchesne out front, drives to the right-hand side. Shovels the ball down low to Bruner. Bruner out on the wing, turn right-hand side. Back down low to Duchesne, then to Rosetta working the baseline. Spins and fires from about 8 feet, and it's good for Rosetta. Rosetta has two.
Hey, 5 seconds on the shot clock!
McKittrick. And high post to Bruner. Back out front quick into McLean. Drives all the way. Lays one up. That's good. McLean saunters up to the timeline. 8 seconds. Time to make something happen. McLean out front between the circles. Launches a long three. That's good. Nailed it from 23 feet. Boom. McLean just nailed one from downtown. He's got 7 points in the basketball game. And at the end of the first period of play, the Cavemen lead by 2.
Good job, Jack. Good job, Jake.
Good job. Come on.
That was left-hand side quickly to Bruner. Make that Rosetta. Right-hand side to Morgan on the wing. Out to the top of the key. That's Bruner. Bruner wants to muscle. Goes down all the way. He lays one up and in, and Bruner gets his first of the basketball game. Rebound put back up by Morgan, and it's good. He slowly picks up the pace right now. Bounce pass left-hand side. Is slapped away by Duchesne out of bounds.
Hey. Guys, just be quiet. Don't say anything. They'll get the tech. Blue, look at me. Keep your mouth shut. Let them get the tech. No talking.
Into the basketball out front. Gives the ball on the give and go. Stolen away by Duchesne to Rosetta. Back to Duchesne. And the Cavemen forced that turnover. Lane bounce pass inside to Bruner. Right hand side then to Rosetta. Rosetta hard to the glass. Gets it up and down. And Rosetta gets it in. And he'll go to the free throw line. Right hand side. Man goes to the floor. Lost his footing. Picked up by McLean. Lee passes up right-hand side to Rosetta. Rosetta drives the baseline, goes up hard to the glass. It's good. And he'll go to the free throw line. Post player. They give a high post to Rosetta. Rosetta elevates from right on the line and gets two, a long two. Time now for period number 4. Grants Pass outscored 22-12 in the third period. Fast comes left-hand side to Rosetta. Wing left-hand side looking for a post player. Gives it high post to Bruner. Bruner checks down the paint. Tries to back down. Spins. Goes up one. Backhand layup. And it's good for Bruner. For a post. Up top then to Rosetta. Rosetta drives. Comes down all the way. Lays one up and in. Right-hand side then to McLean. McLean puts the ball on the floor. Drives to the free throw line. Spins. Comes all the way down. Spins. Fires one up. That is good. By Jesse. Jesse picks it up in the forecourt. Right-hand side, goes to McLean on the wing. McLean head fakes, bounce pass down low to
Bruner spins, elevates, shot up the glass, and balances it. Finally rolls through. Caven picked up by McClain. 3-on-2 break. McClain goes to the left-hand side. Stops in, goes down low to Bruner. Bruner elevates, finally hooks one up. Right-hand side to Deshane. Drives the baseline, kicks the ball left-hand side to McClain. Comes right back from the other side to the free throw line. Drops the ball down low to Rosetta. Rosetta goes hard to the glass and gets it up and down. Check that. That was Bruner. Good move by Bruner. Goes left-hand side to McClain for three from the wing, left-hand side, and it's good. And McClain to Deshane, left-hand side to McClain. McClain tries to attack along the baseline. Works hard. Bounce pass inside to Bruner. Bruner works hard. Muscles one up. Underhanded layup is good.
Here we go. Hey, no matter what, we let them know that we're here. We win or lose, we got to play ball to the wall.
Finish off three. One, two, three.
Come on.
Cross court left-hand side to McClain. Attacks along the baseline. Lays went up. That won't go. Rebound slapped out of Bruner's hands, but retrieved by McClain. Spins and fires for three, and it's good. So McClain finds another three. He's got 15 in the basketball game. Timeout taken by the Cavemen. Fighting back here, back to within six, 60-54, with 2 minutes to play. We'll be back right after this one-minute Caveman timeouter. Flips the ball right back out front to Jesse. Crosses the top of the key. Looks for McClain. Gets it to him on the wing. McClain penetrates, goes up. Plays went up. That's good. Final score, a 10-point win for the Panthers here, 68-58 over the Grants Pass Cavemen.
That wasn't a low point for us, even though that was like a must win for us to win conference. At that point, we were mainly fighting for second, third place to get into the playoffs, because out of all the teams in our league, we were ranked the lowest. We were ranked at 33, which 32 and up go to playoffs, 33 are out. So our backs basically against the wall at South Medford from there on out.
I was mad. I was also dog tired. Because I gave my all in that fourth quarter. Gavin started making some clutch threes and that brought us back in. And I thought, damn, like we're right here. We're about to win this game. I mean, I was happy because we had a good game. Like we played good, we competed with them, but at the same time, it's just annoying when you let those games like that slip away.
It felt like we were right there.
I mean, it just goes back to getting punched in the face, I feel like. I mean, we were all really mad about that one.
So after that South Medford game, we went to Sheldon. Yeah, I think our boys felt really confident in that Sheldon game, mainly because they knew what the recipe for success was. And, you know, it always playing up a Sheldon's tough, right? You know, I think Sheldon and Roseburg are probably the two toughest place we play, and I don't know why it is, but our boys did a really good job that night.
Score 58-45 is the final score.
Boys moved past on that win, and they're dead focused on what they need to do tonight.
Senior night, you want to mention your seniors? How about Luke Morgan?
Well, Luke's a great kid. He's one of our main leaders on the floor when things are going wrong. He's one of those guys that really speak up and is really vocal. Love the kid. I've known him, you know, ever since kindergarten, you know. Gavin McClain, man, that kid's grown. Gavin was our main leader this summer, and he grew up. He went from boy to man this year. He did a lot of good things. He had to learn a lot of things, and he did some really, really good stuff this year, this summer. Really, really proud of that young man that he's become. And
next one is a kid by the name of Jaden. What's his last name? Jesse again. I'm going to talk about him a little.
Yeah, Jaden, my only son. You know, I feel like he's the best defensive player in our league. And, you know, he's a great teammate. He's one of our other leaders. He leads more by example. He's not a very boisterous leader. He's more of an energy bunny. and just does a great job.
You have one more senior, I think, Bushmeyer.
Phenomenal kid. He's super, super strong, super tough, and he's a resilient kid. That kid's been through a lot, and super proud of the young man that he is as well. And then we also have Tyler Ireland. He's our manager.
Mm-hmm.
He's our senior.
Has no minutes this year.
He has no minutes this year, and he's been a lifesaver to help us. He's been a mouthpiece for some of us coaches when things aren't going the way that we want him to, and he's our fifth senior.
Yeah, I mean, senior night for me wasn't like that emotional. Like I just wanted to play, and so I mean, I was ready mentally. I mean, I watched the film. I did all that. I was preparing for about a week before.
Once it came, I was locked in. I wasn't even ready about, like, I didn't even care about walking out here. I just wanted to play.
This is our game to win, okay? And they have to punch us in the mouth and take it from us.
To 52,
the Grants Pass Caveman
stealing the ball and getting that fast break dunk after Micah got his too. I mean, that was a good feeling. I felt like I got up right there and I was like, all right, let's keep going. I feel like that, especially at that moment, kind of just, that was a dagger, put him away.
I just got back from like having bronchitis and the flu. I got pulled out a lot of times during that game. I was a little upset, but I understood completely because I think Jordan stepped up in a big way and was able to fill my position well. And Jaden and Peyton throwing in some like nice dunks was pretty cool. Brought the energy back, I felt like, for sure. But the biggest part, I think, was Zach and Gavin's defense, and Peyton for sure on defense locking up Micah during that game. He did very well during that game, and I think that defense was the only reason that we had any chance of winning that game.
Grants Pass and Roseburg never go well together. Those two names don't belong in a sentence together. And so, especially beating them and having it be our senior night and our seniors' last game on our home floor, it really meant a lot to us younger classmen to do that for our seniors.
There was definitely some people on our team who were checked out and just kind of ready to be done with basketball. I mean, I know everyone tried, but I think that we could have done a lot better for sure. But like a lot better.
Practices, I think, the entire week, and they were all great practices, it felt like to me.
all of our energy was up. Felt like everyone was invested in the team. Everyone believed that that was our best matchup that we could have gotten. I think we walked into that game just, I guess, not with the energy that we needed.
They were good. They were better than what we thought. And we pressed, we zoned, we did everything we could, but it wasn't enough. And they were a solid team. They were definitely worthy of that seventh rank.
The biggest thing that pushed me was staying there for Gavin, because I knew that this was his sport. This is his last time being able to play with us as buddies, and this is my last time coaching, or like not being coached by Joel and all of them. And I've been coached by them my entire life. And I think that that really started sitting in as soon as I sat down after I got pulled out at the end of that playoff game. Because I sat next to Gavin after I hugged everybody, and we were just talking for a second, and it just felt like all the memories were coming back. And it's just all fading away, that like this is over now.
That was honestly the only reason I was ever like emotional at all. I wasn't even emotional about like the season ending or nothing. I was just sad that the people I've been playing with since third and fourth grade, like me and, I got a picture on my phone of me and Luke and Jaden at an all-star game for Manny League in like second grade. So it was just the fact that all my boys they're all going to do their stuff, and season's over, so I don't get to play with them ever again. So
it was great to be here. This is a great trip, especially for the kids coming up next year that are gonna have to, or that are returning next year, that this was a good moment to see like this is what we need to do, especially for next time.
Well, for me, it was, I'm gonna be back here. I don't wanna be a first round exit again. You know, that's kind of been the Grant's best way in the past few years, and so I wanna change that with football and basketball. I don't wanna be first round exits anymore. And once we got in that locker room, there was tears, there was sadness, but then there was some really highs. Like, what a great season we had with everything that went wrong. You know, T-Mac going down, who was our starter, one of our leading scorers, and one of our best defenders. So him going down and all the sickness and the injuries we had to fight, it was still a great season for what we did.
This year to me, I feel like I've grown more as a person. And I think of like the moments, not so much like the total season. When I look back on the season, I think more of the moments, like seeing everybody come together as a community to come watch us play every Friday night. It's fun.
The best part is just hanging out with my brothers and getting to practice and play with them every single day.
And just having fun. I mean, that's probably the biggest take that I'll take from basketball. I mean, I'm a track guy. Like it's what I do, but basketball, I stayed with it because I had fun. I mean, growing up with these guys, like, I mean, I kind of have left. Getting those dunks was awesome. I mean, I had to carry on the tradition from Mason, so.
You know, I think every year is a little bit different, but I always go back to teaching boys that it's not just the game of basketball, the game of life. We always talk about that a lot. Coach Olson, and I talk about that frequently when we're with the boys quite a bit. You know, just the, you know, how a game of basketball translates to the game of life. You're gonna have ups and downs of life, and you know, you're gonna make bad decisions in life, and you're gonna make good decisions in life. It's how fast you recover. So, you know, I always want my boys to know, and they all know that I hate to lose, right? They, every single one knows. And when I coach girls, but at the end of the day, you know, they know that I care for them, they know that I love them, and they know that they know that I want them to succeed in life and after life. And I'm hoping that the game of basketball teaches them life lessons, but they also create a brotherhood and a group of friends that they'll always be able, like I had growing up, that they'll be able to depend on. But you know, it's always going to be our effort, attitude, and toughness. And if you can control those three elements, that you'll be pretty successful. If you diss us, we won't even think of. We'll nip of the dog and give a big shove. This rhythm really fits like a snug glove. Like a box of positives, it's a plus love. As the trial flies high like a dove.
kick it?
Yes, you can.
Can I 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 kick it?
Yes, you can.
Well, I'm born.
Born, then.
Can I kick it? To my tribe that flows in layers. Right now, Fife is a point sayer. At times, I'm a studio conveyor. Mr. Dinkins, would you please be my mayor? You'll be doing us a really big favor. Boy, this track really has a lot of flavor. When it comes to rhythms, Quest is your savior. Follow us for the funky behavior. Make a note on the rhythm we gave ya. Feel free, drop your pants, yeah, yeah, hey, yeah. Do you like the garments that we wear? I instruct you to be the obeyer. A rhythm recipe that you'll savor. Doesn't matter if you're minor or major. Yes, the tribe of the game with a player. As you inhale like a breath of fresh air.
No facilities, cause some don't agree with how I do this. I get straight and meditate like a Buddhist. I'm dropping flavor, my behavior is hereditary, but my technique is very necessary. Blame it on Ice Cube, because he said it get funky when you got a subject and a predicate. Add it on a dope beat and it'll make you think. Some suckers just tickle me pink to my stomach, cause they don't flow like this one. You know what, I won't hesitate to diss one or two before I'm through, so don't try to sing this. Some drop science, well I'm dropping English, even if Yella makes it a cappella. I still express you, I don't smoke weed or sets, cause it's known to give a brother brain damage. And brain damage on the mic don't manage nothing but making a sucker in you equal. Don't be another sequel.
Spread yourself.
The pop chart. So where should a brother like you start expressing yourself, my boy, and show you how your track.
What up?
Drop English, right about